गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन, वेलकम टू ऑनलाइन क्लासेस ऑफ गुरुकुल कुरुक्षेत्र। आई एम नवदीप सिंह, एन इंग्लिश टीचर। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट पोएम नंबर 1 ऑफ 7th क्लास। इट इज द स्क्वेयर। दिस पोएम इज कंपोज्ड बाय मिल्ड्रेड बावर्स आर्मस्ट्रांग, बोर्न इन 1901, डाइड इन 1984। शी वॉज एन अमेरिकन पोएट। She was such a great poet that she won Yale Younger Poets Prize even during her first poetic collection. She used to write her poetic collection under her pseudonym. The meaning of pseudonym is a fictitious name, or you can say an imaginary name, because every female poet used to write under pseudonym because they did not have full rights at that time. So let's dive in the topic. This poem, The Squirrel, is very keenly observed by the poet. The poet observes every activity of the squirrel. She observes playfulness of the squirrel, a natural animal. It is like a rodent. It is like a small rabbit. Its color she discusses in the poem. She discusses its naughtiness in the poem. She also observes shyness of this natural animal. She also notices the rolling of its tail, because its shape is like a question mark, and she also says that it is a teasing animal. Whenever someone goes near to it, it goes other way. It is like a rodent and it looks like a small rabbit. So now let's begin the poem. He wore a question mark for tail. The poem tells everything to us that the squirrel is having its tail like a question mark. Its tail is like a sign of interrogation. The shape of its tail is like sign of interrogation. An overcoat of gray. The color of its body is gray. It has brown strips on its body. He sat up straight to eat a nut. The squirrel sat up straight to eat a nut. He liked to tease and play. The squirrel likes to tease and play. It teases the poet. And if we rein around his tree, when the poet goes near to the tree, it goes the other way. Means, due to its shyness, due to its naughtiness, it teases the poet. It goes the other way. So this is your poem, dear students. Now we are going to discuss the technical aspect of the poem. Dear students, first of all, we'll discuss the rhyming scheme of the poem. Tail, this is A, gray is B, nut is C, and gray and play both are having rhyming scheme. So that's why the rhyming scheme of the poem is A, B, C, B. Now, I want to tell you that figure of speech which are used by the poet in the poem. Number one is personification. Personification is a type of figure of speech in which non-living things are presented as living. For example, love is blind. Love is an abstract idea. Love is a feeling. So, it has been shown here as a lively thing. So same is here. The poet is giving human qualities to the natural animal, the squirrel. The poet is giving human qualities to this natural animal. So that's why he is using he here means everywhere he is using he. That's why this is personification. Next one is alliteration. What is alliteration? I'm going to define it. What is alliteration? Repetition of a sound, whether it can be found in the nearby words or it can be found in continuous words also. Like in the poem, we see two T's is there. So T word is used here and T is also used by the poet here. So two T's, the alliteration is here. Again, I am giving an example of alliteration also. She sells a sofa. So she sells a sofa. S word is there in first alphabet and in second also. So that's why alliteration is there. She sells a sofa. So this is your poem. And we will meet in next video. Thanks. Have a nice day. Thanks.